Hi, I'm Andrew Richardson, and I'm talking about depression and depression recovery. I'm that very rare animal, a depression recovery optimist. And my aim in these podcasts is to open you to the truth that your depression can be easily understood and relieved, and quickly too. Now, in this podcast, I will have to watch myself, as I would hate to be accused of exhibiting dismissive superiority to my betters. Because Norman's experience with me, Norman is not his real name, of course, was one of such rapid transformation that it would be hard not to question the NHS psychiatrists under whose care Norman was, and not to wonder what the hell they were about, and who the hell are they kidding? Norman was in his early 20s, who came to see me seriously depressed, on heavy antidepressant medication, exhibiting classic OCD checking behaviours, and under the outpatient care of an NHS psychiatrist. At his first session, Norman scored 30 on the core system I use, which is severe distress. He was sleeping badly and in particular waking up exhausted. He was spending far too much time on his own and really struggling at work in media marketing. He also said that he had been under a number of NHS psychiatrists over the years and none had helped him or he liked particularly or had any respect for, though the latest was decent enough. At our second session, Norman's core score had fallen to 19, and by the third session, he was just scoring 4, an indicator of robust emotional health. And 6 weeks later, after that session, he came around again as a checkup, and he was flying. Now, how did I help Norman so quickly? Well, at that first session, it quickly became evident that Norman had a clear and vivid access to memories that were still strongly arousing him. These concerned his early lonely and excluded experiences at his secondary school and later relationship experiences that had gone badly wrong. I explained the situation to Norman as follows. That strong and uncontrolled emotions arising as a trauma-like memory outside of his conscious control had been a constant feature of his life for many years, and that his way of coping with this had made matters worse. He had evolved OCD behaviours as an attempt to be more in control. Additionally, his self-confidence in group situations had been drained away, and this led to excessive worrying and exhausting overdreaming, which he also sought to control by OCD checking behaviours. To my surprise, Norman was a good trance subject, which is often not the case for those on significant medication. And as his memories were so strong, it was clear that they could be detraumatized quite easily. And this was done in that first session, using the rewind method. The effect was to calm Norman and allow him to begin to regain control of his emotions. And then what happened for Norman was what could be confidently anticipated, namely that his self-confidence would grow, especially in social situations, and his OCD behaviours, already weakening, would disappear completely. I wrote a letter to his NHS psychiatrist after Norman saw him for the last time, curious to see if he might acknowledge his incapacity to help Norman and maybe be interested in how I had helped Norman. And did he? What do you think?